In this video, we're going to look at repeating tables, and we're going to start getting a bit into relational structures, so relational database structures. So we're going to skip question 14 and 15 for now and dive straight into section 2.1. So let's start setting that up together. So returning to our ComCare form, again, I'm going to collapse all. I'm going to select the last section we were working on, add a group question, and so we need to obviously put in the label and ID, display text and question ID. And then our first question is a multiple choice question with single answer. So it's either going to be free or a fee of service or full charge, etc., etc. So add a question, multiple choice. This is going to, so they don't actually have a title for this question. So let's just call this service charges as well. And then the options. And I'm just going to copy paste this and keep adding choices. And we can leave this in. So fee for service subsidized, full service charge, commercial for profit, and insurance. Okay, next question. If applicable, indicate the fees for the following services. So we have a few questions here. And then one here, which is actually multiple questions. So we want to create a list of other specific charges. So first of all, what I'm going to do is, as all of these questions, all of these fields relate to this one question, I'm going to make this a group question. So let's insert a question group. And let's call it indicate the fees for the following services. Let me just capitalize. And then we can start adding in the different questions. So these are all numeric questions. And again, I'm going to leave it unrequired. So that should be bed fee per night or day. And then this last one, medication. Okay. And then we have a list of other specific charges. So these can be multiple, and we don't really know how long this list is going to be. I mean, an alternative is that we write other one, other two, other three. But again, if we have more than three other specific charges, we want the flexibility to be able to add those. And that's where repeat groups come in handy. So let's see where we can find them. Add questions, groups, repeat group. Great. And now they want to know the questions. What are the questions that need to be repeated? Well, again, we want the fee, and we also want the name. So is it a lab test? Is it a surgical intervention? So we can say name of other charge. Oh, sorry. So the name of this group is obviously a list of other specific charges. And then the first question is a text question. And that's name of other charge. And then we'll make that required. Or let's leave it unrequired in case they don't need to add other specific charges. And then let's add in a number question. So, cost of other service. And again, let's leave it unrequired. And the user, the mobile worker, will be able to indicate how many times they need to add another specific charge. So again, let's open up our BlueStacks and see what this looks like. So I'm going to save and publish and update within BlueStacks. So having updated the application in my BlueStacks and having skipped forward to our service charge question, so service charge sector here, we can see, well, I need to first select, make a selection here. We also should have added display logic, because if I say that service charges, that there are no service charges or that service charges are free, it should skip all the next questions, right? So we can always add that later. So full service charge, and then, okay, so how much for the consultation OPD? If there is zero, we should indicate zero. If they don't know how much it is, they should just skip it, and it is skippable. So we can just enter some data here. And then our next question should be the repeat table. And there we go. So it asks us, do you want to add a new list of other specific charges group? So we're going to say yes, add group. And let's look at some of the examples that they give us here. So lab tests, for example. So name of other charge, lab tests. And then the cost of the service. And then it asks us, do we want to add another group on top of this? Sure. What else do we have? Surgical interventions. Okay. And how much are surgical interventions? 400. Great. And then if we're done with our list, we could say, no, do not add, I'm finished. And that automatically submits the form as well.